House version of the bill empowers the commission to determine the method and procedure for voting and transmission of results, whereas that for the Senate in subclause 4 requires the commission to seek the approvals of both the NCC, that's the Communications Commission, and the National Assembly before deploying electronic means to transmit results. Now, this next slide. Now, this particular disparity, this clause is very important for a lot of citizens, because we believe that the empowering INEC to deploy technology in transmitting results would promote transparency in the process. And I think there's a lot of controversies around it. But what is important for us is to state that this proposal is not supposed to substitute the manual process, because the Electoral Commission will still have the manual process. But what we want is a law that empowers INEC to transmit results, just so that if individuals want to challenge the outcome of an election relying on the data from the results uploaded on the INEC results portal, that the court would adopt those evidences or information that they had retrieved from the INEC portal. Because if we don't have this in the law, when you talk about the hierarchies of laws, what you're going to see is the electoral law would always supersede the policy. So we do not want an important provision like this to be a matter of policy. We want it in the law, just so that INEC has that legal mandate to transmit results electronically, which is why we believe that the House proposal should be adopted at conference, because that way INEC's independence is not undermined. One, INEC is empowered to make the decision to on when it comes to how or the procedure for voting and the procedure for transmitting results. We've seen INEC test run the BVAS, the bimodal voter authentication system. INEC just did a pilot in Bayelsa state constituency elections. We've seen it was successful. We had observed that process as at 8:30 on elections day, every result from the 84 polling units were uploaded. And what this BVAS does, it integrates the Z-pad. The Z-pad was was deployed in Edo and Ondo last year. And we saw that that was effective. So INEC already says, we can do this. We have the capacity to do this. Give us the legal mandate to actually transmit results electronically. And while the major reason we have a problem with the proposal by the Senate is because INEC is a body created by the Constitution, is established as a federal executive body. The NCC is a creation of an act of Parliament. Now, we cannot subject the power of a constitutionally established body to the decision of an institution created by an act of Parliament. That's one. The second, Section 78 of the Constitution also gives INEC the discretion to make decisions over the conduct of elections.
First and foremost, I want to say that it is a misconstruction of Nigerian law to say that the provision of Section 52.3 as provided in the Senate version is without constitutional support. And I read what the Senate have recommended in the bill. The Commission may consider electronic transmission of results, provided that the national coverage is adjudged to be adequate and secured by the NCC and approved by the National Assembly. The argument that INEC is independent in 78 or Section 2 of the Constitution is without doubt, but paragraph 22 of the exclusive legislative list, which pursuant to Section 4 of the Constitution give the National Assembly power to make law, include the power to prescribe the mode of election. And that is why Section 52 specifically said that open secret ballot, INEC can then now use its procedure in accordance with Section 52 to come up with procedure which may include electronic voting. But when it comes to electronic transmission, the other language that was brought by the committee, Gaia committee, which was approved by the House of Rep, reads, the commission may transmit result of election by electronic means where and when practicable. With respect, I'm a scholar in law and at the least outstanding modest, I have been PhD in law. Where and when practicable is nebulous, vague, and give evil discretion that in the context of the same election, for instance, in my senatorial district, you can say you are transmitting results from Oshogbo local government and refuse to transmit results in the federal local government or in Boduadu local government. So we feel that why should we leave this important aspect to discretion of the commission? So the question of now independence is not affected. By item 22, we can make law. In fact, if INEC is totally independent, absolutely autonomous, there will be no need to make any electoral law. So, but of course, we have the conference session that is coming. We are open to discussion and appropriate language, but we cannot have to get applause from the public, do something that would do monumental injury to the integrity of our electoral process. So that's our rationale. And we affirm legal advice that within paragraph 22 of the exclusive legislative list, we have the competence to make law as they were made.